from the flames that you walk through. No one to talk to but ghosts that'll haunt you, thoughts that you taunt you. Trying to heal, but the battle's uphill, and if God is for real, you just wonder if he'll listen.
What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel, back with another video. Now, if you saw the recent BET Awards, I'm sure by now you've seen reviews of Will Smith's performance and his continuation of his redemption tour, his media tour, trying to get him some get back after that epic slap heard around the world at the Oscars. And y'all, I've been on this platform, and I've seen so many voices, so many personalities reviewing his performance. And I have to say, y'all, as I've taken in the performance and viewed it and listened to it and observed it, I think differently than a lot of people that I've seen review this thing. Now, we're not going to play it here for copyright reasons, but y'all go search it, check it out, and look at Will Smith's performance. I listened to the lyrics of the song. I thought it was a positive message. And if you follow Will Smith's rap career from the beginning, like I have, you know he's always been a kind of positive dude, not really cursing and talking bad in his music. He's always had some kind of message. I think he's continuing with that even in his elder years. But when I look at the performance and I look at the setting, I say, man, here we go again. I understand, even the vloggers that I disagree with, I understand why they took the perspective they took. Because when you look at it, you see red all over the screen. You see fire, you see smoke. And it immediately takes you back to some evil performances that we've seen on award shows. And you can look at it and say, well, this is no different. I get it, y'all. I get it. But I'm listening to the lyrics. I'm listening to the intent. And I know that we as observers can't identify what's going on in a man's heart. And I say, maybe he changed. Maybe he faced the worst trial of his life and got closer to God. This sounds like a God message. So when I hear the criticism, and most of it is surrounding him doing a collab with gospel artists, not sure if I agree with that, because we got Chandler Moore of Maverick City Music, which is not gospel in my opinion. That's CCM. That's a whole different ball of wax over there. But we know that Chandler has a voice and he can do that. He can do gospel. He can do R&B. He's very versatile. So he put himself in this position. Why? Because he can make himself fit into the mold of this narrative. And then we got the godfather of disrespecting God himself, Kirk Franklin. Lord, he comes out. And you know, this is my beef with the whole situation, is that we sat back as Christians, as believers, and we let the industry redefined gospel over time. It didn't happen suddenly. This has happened over decades. And we should have known something when the man stood in front of the mic and said, those of you who think gospel music has gone too far, you ain't seen nothing yet. Red flags should have went up all over the place. When we saw him introduce P-Funk and samples of Parliament Funkadelic and call it gospel, because the Spirit of God makes you want to stomp, we should have known then. Well, y'all, seemed like church folks didn't do nothing. Church folks sat by passively, and now here we are. I remember, y'all, I'm old enough to remember when they would have award shows like the Grammys, and they give a Grammy to a gospel artist, and they let them perform. And somehow, the whole mood of the environment would change. Seemed like it would go from party mode, from award show mode, to we gonna settle down and respect this. We may not be believers, we may not be devout Christians, but there's a certain level of respect for what they're doing. Certain amount of respect for the music, for the artistry, for the worship. And we gonna be respectful. Y'all, now when you look at BET and Will Smith coming out here and making songs with reference to God and linking up with Chandler Moore and Kirk Franklin, you wouldn't be surprised if you saw somebody start twerking to this. Because this is what society and this entertainment industry has devolved into over the years. I get it. I'm not a stranger to it. I'm not a prude. But I'm willing at this juncture to give this man a chance because what we've been doing ain't working. What they've been rapping about is turning folks to the devil, turning folks to sin, turning folks to hell. So when a man says, I'm going to grab the mic and I'm going to talk positive, I get it, bro. I understand the criticism, though, because you're talking in the fire. You're talking in the smoke. You're talking with the red background. It throws people off. It triggers folks. It brings us back to the Grammy Awards with Sam Smith and other artists out there doing all sorts of devilment on stage. Seems like these folks who put this stuff together, the stage hands, the stage managers, the folks who plan out these performances, seem like they can't do without the fire, can't do without the smoke, can't do without the evil imagery, even in a song as positive as this. Y'all, pray for the culture, pray for society, pray for the industry, because I tend to believe when I see things like this, I tend to believe that this is the best they can do. Like, this is the best y'all can come up with on a positive song. You got to get Kirk. You got to bring in Chandler Moore. This the best you can do? Well, if that's it, then God help us, because we down bad. When I say we, I mean all of us, all of society, all of us believers, all of us who grew up on gospel music and know it to be something different than this. Y'all, we down bad because we have sat by idly and let the industry redefine what worshipful music sounds like. And for that, we should repent, each and every one of us. Y'all, what do you think about this? Don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and share the video so we can get more people involved in the conversation, y'all. And like I always say, always remember and never forget. Without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time, peace.